Welcome back to your free training course for Windows 7. In this video, I will look at Bitlocker. Bitlocker is a technology that allows you to encrypt your entire hard disk, including the operating system. The reason you would want to do this is to protect your computer's data if it is stolen. With Windows 7, you also have the option to encrypt a data drive, a feature not available in Windows Vista until the release of Service Pack 1. Products such as Bitlocker are important because many companies consider the data on the laptop to be more valuable than the laptop. If the data on the laptop were to get into the wrong hands, a company could lose its competitive advantage. Windows 7 and Bitlocker help secure your data by making it impossible to perform what is referred to as an offline attack. An offline attack is when you remove the hard disk from the computer and place it into another computer. From here, you can access the files on the hard disk by bypassing the need to have a username and password. The second type of offline attack is when you leave the hard disk in the computer and boot the computer into another operating system, usually from a DVD. Types of boot disks include Windows PE and Linux recovery disks. BitLocker prevents this from occurring by looking at the startup process used to boot the computer. If the boot process is not the one that it is expecting, for example, an attempt is made to boot with Windows PE, the hard disk will not be readable. It is also recommended that you use BitLocker with Trusted Platform Module, or TPM. A TPM is a chip on the motherboard. BitLocker uses this chip to hold the encryption keys and check the boot-up sequence. If the startup sequence is correct, the TPM chip will allow the hard disk to be unencrypted. The TPM chip stores cartographic keys, but you can also get BitLocker to work without a TPM. For example, you could store the keys on a USB key instead. When you boot the computer, you simply need to insert the USB key on startup. Once the system is booted, you can remove the USB key and put it in a safe place. Before you can start using BitLocker, your system needs to meet a few requirements. First, you need to be running Windows 7 Enterprise or Ultimate Edition. BitLocker also requires a 100 megabyte system partition, as shown. When you install Windows 7, this partition will be created automatically, but the partition will not be given a drive letter, so you may not have even known it existed. If this partition does not exist, don't worry. When you configure BitLocker in Windows 7, the partition will be created automatically. Next, if you're going to use a TPM, the TPM chip needs to be version 1.2 or higher. If Windows 7 is not detecting your TPM chip, then it may need to be enabled in the BIOS. Once you meet the requirements for BitLocker, you next need to decide what mode to run it in. The first mode is TPM only. When the computer starts up, a system check is performed, and if the computer is booting up the way it is expected, then the operating system will start. This means that if a person were to steal your computer, they could still boot the computer up without any usernames or keys. Assuming a username and password has been set in Windows, the thief will be stopped at the login screen. The thief will need to know a username and password to access the computer. Since the hard disk is encrypted, the thief will not be able to use an offline attack on the computer. Of course, the thief could reformat the computer and use it that way, but at least you know that your information is safe as it will be destroyed in that process. The next mode is TPM with a PIN. When the computer is started up, the user is prompted for a PIN. Without this PIN, the computer cannot start. The next form of security is TPM with a USB key. Rather than trying to remember a PIN, you can store a key on a USB key that is read during boot up. If the computer is always on, you could store the USB key in a safe. If the computer crashes or needs to be rebooted, you could get the USB key out of the safe and then use it to start the computer. If you want more security, you can use the TPM chip with a USB key and a PIN. This is the most secure form of security. Lastly, if you do not have a TPM chip in your computer, you can use the computer with just a USB key. Regardless of which method you use, If you don't have the correct key or keys, or the operating system boot process changes, for example, the BIOS is upgraded, the computer will go into TPM recovery mode. This mode allows you to recover your system in the event that you lose your key or change your hardware. Let's look at how to configure BitLocker on a Windows 7 computer. First of all, I will open Disk Management from the Start menu. Normally, when you install Windows 7, a separate partition will be created. On this system, I installed Windows 7, making sure that there was only one partition on the hard disk. If I close Disk Management and open the Control Panel, to access BitLocker, open System and Security, and then select BitLocker Drive Encryption. To configure BitLocker, select the option Turn on BitLocker to start the BitLocker wizard. Once Windows does a quick check of your system to make sure it meets the requirements, the wizard will inform you of the steps it needs to do in order to get BitLocker configured. On this system, the BitLocker partition needs to be created. This partition will contain a small operating system. Since the C drive will be encrypted, it will not be accessible without some bootstrap software to interface with the TPM chip and start Windows 7. This partition is where that software lives. The next step is that the TPM chip needs to be configured to work with Windows 7. Lastly, the drive needs to be encrypted. Once I press Next, I get a message reminding me that it is a good idea to back up my data before proceeding. Once I press Next, BitLocker will start creating the partition it needs to operate. This does take a few minutes, so I will speed up the process. Once complete, if I now open Disk Management again, you can see a 300 megabyte partition has been created for BitLocker. BitLocker only requires a 100 megabyte partition, but don't be surprised if you see a 200 megabyte or 300 megabyte partition here. Microsoft allows third parties to store their own recovery tools in this partition alongside BitLocker, so the partition may be larger than 100 megabytes. I will now reboot the computer, speeding up the process so we don't have to wait. Once the system has rebooted and you have logged back in, the BitLocker wizard will automatically start off again from where it left off. Once I press Next, the next step is to configure the TPM hardware. This, unfortunately, does require another restart. During the computer startup, a screen will appear asking you to confirm that TPM ownership will be changed. In order for the TPM to be used by Windows, the ownership of the TPM needs to be given to Windows, so I will press F1. Once the operating system starts up again and I log back in, the BitLocker wizard will once again start up. The last step of the process is to encrypt the hard disk. Once I press Next, I will be asked where to save the recovery key. The recovery key is required if you ever move the hard disk to another computer or, for some reason, you can't access the hard disk. You have three options. The recovery key can be saved to a USB flash drive, to a file, or even printed out. Regardless of which option you select, you need to keep the data in a safe place and don't keep it on the hard disk that you encrypt. If you do, you will not be able to read the file if you lose access to the hard disk. In this case, I will save the recovery key to a USB flash drive. If I open Windows Explorer and open the recovery file, notice the BitLocker recovery key is at the bottom. This is the key that you will need to enter in if you ever need to recover the system. Now that I have the recovery key saved, I will close the file and continue the wizard. On the next screen, I can select the option Run BitLocker System Check. What this does is it checks the recovery key on the USB flash drive to ensure that it can be used to recover the system. Although this step is not required, I would recommend performing it so you know the recovery key is working correctly. You don't want to find out this fact when you are trying to recover the hard disk later on. Windows 7 will once again want to restart the computer. I have accelerated this process so we don't have to wait. Once the computer has rebooted and I am logged in again, notice at the bottom right-hand corner the balloon telling us the drive is being encrypted. If I click the balloon, I can see the progress of encrypting the hard drive. While this is happening, I can still use the operating system, but it is not a good idea to stop the process, for example, shutting down or rebooting the system. The entire hard disk needs to be encrypted, including free space, so the process does take a long time to complete. I will pause the video and return once it is complete. If I now open the control panel, go back to System and Security, and open BitLocker drive encryption, I have a few options for BitLocker. If I want to remove BitLocker completely, I can select the option Turn Off BitLocker. This will decrypt the hard disk and remove BitLocker. The next option, Suspend Protection, will temporarily disable some of the features of BitLocker. If you are planning on changing part of the startup process, including upgrading the BIOS, you will need to suspend protection. If you do not perform this step, BitLocker will think the system has been tampered with, and BitLocker will boot into recovery mode. The next option, Manage BitLocker, allows you to resave or print the recovery key for BitLocker in case you lost it. Down at the bottom left-hand side of the screen, you have the option TPM Administration. Selecting this option will allow you to perform administrative actions on the Trusted Platform module. This concludes how to set up BitLocker on Windows 7. In the next video, I will look at setting up BitLocker to go. In the video after this, I will look at setting up a data recovery agent for BitLocker. For more videos in this free training course, please see our webpage or YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.